Now here's an example of a function that's tremendously useful for folks that are working with real-time data. It's the time filtered option. What we can do with this, let's look at the arguments here, is you can use an expression and then figure out how long in seconds, hours, minutes, etc., that expression has been true for a single or multiple periods of time. So let me give you an example. We have a pi tag that we use for a lot of training called sinusoid. It's a simple sine wave that goes from 0 to 100 twice every 24 hours. So chances are in any given day, it's going to be about 50% of the time above 50. So let's take a look at an expression in which we can actually verify my hunch that it's going to be about 12 hours out of every 24 hours, it's going to be above 50. I can specify an expression. Now I'm going to start this expression either with two single quotes or put the whole thing in parentheses. Remember, you have that issue. If you start the name of a tag in an expression, then Excel uses that first single quote as a format specifier. So I like to resolve that by starting everything with a parentheses. I'll say sinusoid greater than 50. That's my expression. Very simple expression. How long has sinusoid been greater than 50? For this, I'll go back. Let's go from yesterday plus 7 hours to today plus 7 hours. We're just interested in one day at this point. And we'll put the end result right here. So in order to calculate that, I'll choose time filtered. Here's my expression reference. Start time and end time. No interval this time. And we can show the percentage of good data if we want or not. I can choose hours, minutes, seconds, or days. Let's go with hours. And there we go. That's kind of what my guess was for close to 12 hours during that period. It's been greater than 50. And of course, if I were to make a change to this, we would see appropriately what the result is. Now, I just did that for a single result, but there's no reason you couldn't do this for multiple results. Let's go back and let's look at how we would do this calculation for, say, the last, let's go with the last 7 days. Today is Tuesday, so let's go with last Wednesday plus 7 hours. Now you notice we've already modified the calculation now, the result's there. We'll go from Wednesday 7 to today at 7. But now we'll choose one day, so we're going to see a series of results. I'll bring this back up either by doing a right click and choosing time filtered, or you can also, remember, you can also do this by just selecting the output and choosing the function again. This time I'm going to add a time interval, and I'd like to show the start time as well. Now the end result now is we're seeing that for the period beginning, since I showed start time, this is the period beginning the 7th of July at 7 o'clock, about 11.9 hours, it was greater than 50, 11.9, 12.05, etc. So, you know, pretty much my hunch is correct. About 12 hours a day, it's above it. It's a very, very useful function because now we can see exactly how long that's been greater than 50. Now, one of the more interesting things I think you can do with this is if you figure out how long it's been greater than 50, you can easily extrapolate from that and figure out how long it's been within a certain range. So, for example, let's pretend this isn't a goofy little training sine wave. Let's say this is the main reactor temperature. And you'd like to figure out what each of your different shifts do with regard to keeping that within spec. And within spec means greater than 50, less than 80. So how are they doing that? How long are they keeping that greater than 50, less than 80? Pretty simple. I'll go in here. Let's say sinusoid greater than 50 and sinusoid less than 80. This is going to tell us how long that's been true per day.